Okay, let's talk about partnership distributions. Now, with partnership distributions, that means, hey, the partnership's given me cash, the partnership's given me property. How much goes into my personal balance sheet? What we're looking at is, what is my basis that I'm going to pick this asset up for? So a couple of questions. First of all, what is the basis in the received asset? What does it do to my outside basis? And does it create income? Do I have some sort of income that I have to recognize? So let's kind of draw this picture that we did earlier, and we'll do it again, and then we'll go through a bunch of beautiful examples to illustrate what it is we're talking about. So we've got here, this is the partner. And remember, I'm putting an asset into the partnership. Boom. Then I take my share out. In other words, I own 1/3 or 50% or 20%. So let's say I take an asset, carryover basis 10, fair market value 20, I put it in. What is it? Carryover basis. So they pick it up at 10. Let's say we have income of $60. $60. So my basis is 10. That's outside the partnership. Then we have $60. I get 10%. I pick up $6. So my basis is now 16. This is my basis outside the partnership, but the basis of the property to the partnership is inside, and that basis is 10 bucks. So you can see the outside, my basis standing outside the partnership is now what my initial basis was, plus my share of the income, minus this, plus that, whatever, is 16. That's my outside. That's the word outside. That is this number way over here, outside basis. However, the partnership's now going to distribute an asset to me. When they distribute this asset to me, we have to look at what is the basis to them inside, what is my basis outside. So when I talk about inside, outside, that's what you need to understand. So we're going to go through a bunch of scenarios. The rules are different for cash. The rules are different for property. So we've got to understand the rules for cash. We have to understand the rules for property. And we've got to see, is there going to be some sort of income? So the question's going to be, what is my basis in the newly received asset? And is there any income? So now the partnership's going to give me an asset. So that is called the basis in received asset. How much do I pick it up for? Does it create any kind of income? That's what we're looking at with partnership distributions. In your notes, it says, a distribution of assets from a partnership to a partner reduces the partner's basis in the partnership. The amount by which the partner's basis is reduced depends on several factors. Then it says non-liquidating, also called a current distribution. The partner continues in the business after the distribution. So current distribution means it's kind of like a dividend where I own my stock and they give me something. So it's continuing, I'm still around. It says liquidating, this is when the distribution that I'm receiving is in settlement of the entire interest in the business. That would be my entire outside interest. All right. So it says normally non-liquidating dividends versus liquidating. So it says non-liquidating, and you'll see the word cash distributions. The excess of cash over the basis is a gain. Property distributions, the basis in the distributed asset in the hands of the partner is equal to the partner's basis in the partnership prior to the distribution. And here's an example for non-liquidating. Then we'll go through liquidating. So let me kind of set this up so we can see the different options for both liquidating and non-liquidating and see what happens. So over here, I'm gonna do non-liquidating called a current distribution. We'll do this first. Okay, so let's say, for example, I have my outside basis. Let's say my outside basis in the partnership is $10. Let's say I'm getting cash. So in the first case, I'm going to get cash of $2. In the second case, I'm going to get $15. Okay. So in the first case, I have an outside basis of 10. I'm going to get cash of 2. That means what's left? $8. So here, is there any kind of gain or loss? No, because I still have a basis. Let's do the second one. Cash. I have an outside basis of 10. They're giving me 15 bucks. That means, remember, wow, this is it can't go negative, right? So it goes to 0. I have a $5 gain. And that would be a capital gain. Let's do property. Outside basis is 10, and I get property. And let's use the same numbers. Let's say the inside basis of the property to the partnership is 2, or let's say it's 15. 2 or 15. All right. In the first case, it's 2. So I'm getting the property of 2. I still have a basis left of 8. No gain or loss. Next one. Let's say the basis is 15. So starting out, I have an outside basis of 10. I get 15, but guess what? You only pick it up for 10. Why? Because you can never have no gain or loss on property distribution. Remember that. No gain or loss on property distribution. So then what does that mean? It really means that when we're looking at this side, we're going to pick it up at the lower of inside or outside. Lower of inside or outside. So what we're going to do is when we're getting this property distribution, remember, you always pick it up for the lower of inside or outside. What's lower, 2 or 10? 2. Pick it up at 2. What's lower, 10 or 15? Pick it up at 10. Because you can't have a gain or loss on property. Can you have a gain or loss on cash? Yes. Here, I still have balance left. Here, it went negative. What does that mean? It means, hey, I got my basis back. The rest is like a capital gain.